Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is the first video of the series Workday XSLD, right? So this is the first video. It's all about XML. I'm going to present you three XMLs, and based on that, I'm going to build XSLD on those three examples in the first few videos. And as I have promised, right, I'm going to create one article for each video. So even for this video, I have created one article. I'm going to give link for the description. Link for that article in this description, and I'm going to add this video as well in that article. That way it's easier for you to follow along. So let's get started. So this is the article I was referring to. So in this video, in this article, the first bullet point is a video and three examples for XSLD. XML, not XSLD, sorry about that. So let's get started with the first one, right? I'm sure you're already familiar with XML, most of you, or I'm not going to the too many details, but I just wanted to cover few of the keywords what we are going to use. You can always refer to screenshots, right, in this article. That's not a problem. So the first line is called prologue. It will define the version and encoding methods and all, right? And there will be only one root element, and this is how it will have, you know, there's an end here, and it will have all the child root elements, and see, this row has four child elements and root has 1, 2, 3 child elements, right? And then this is how the comments looks, right? So if you have Notepad++ or any other editor for that matter, right, you can place the same data here, and you can choose the language as XML. If you don't have language XML, you can download and add to your list of languages. That way you can see the color coding and row numbers and everything. It's easier for you to analyze, especially if the data is huge. Like, let's just say 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 rows, it's easier for you to view in this Notepad++, right? And one other cool feature about Notepad++ is it will show the closing, you know, ending and starting and ending points of each node, right? And if you highlight a single word, it will highlight all the other words, okay? So this is about the XML. So, and next I'm going to show you the second example, right? In this, I have added few more information. So that is namespace I have added, and I have added attributes. So I have added two attributes in two places, right here, here, and here. And then a namespace, and I have given the description as well. This is called the namespace. If you observe, see here, it's, if you observe, the namespace is defined. The name of the namespace is AB. I can write anything. I can just write as Ujjwal or Workday or anything, doesn't matter. But all you have to do is you have to repeat the same namespace wherever you want to use it, right? So that's about the second example. And the third example I'm going to show is the XML generated by the Workday. If you observe, this is the report name I have used. See here, and it has the Workday system has automatically replaced all the spaces with underscores. So it wouldn't like any spaces, right? And then if you observe, WD is the namespace they have used. That's the default. I have observed WD and WS. Some places it is WS, some places it is WD, right? And then dates will be represented in this way, and you know, like this. So get yourself familiarized with this XML content, how the XML file looks, and all the things, right? So that way your success with the XSLD as well is very good, okay? So I hope you learned something today. I'm going to, in the next subsequent videos, I'm going to build XSLD on these XMLs. Okay? Have a nice day. Bye-bye.